In this illustration, we'll see another connection of a spherical capacitor. Here, the figure shows a spherical capacitor of which inner shell is earth and outer shell is supplied charges by a battery. And here we are required to find the effective capacitance of the system. Now, in this situation here, again, we can see if C1 and C2 are the capacitances of annular region between the plates and the outer region of the outer shell of capacitor, the value of C1 is 4 pi epsilon naught AB upon B minus A, the spherical capacitor, and C2 is 4 pi epsilon naught B, the capacitance of shell in its outer region. Now, if we draw its equivalent circuit, here we can see if these two capacitors are connected one after another. Here we can see the outer plate of C2, which is at infinity. We assume it to be connected to earth, or it is always at zero potential. And the middle shell, which is the plate between C1 and C2, it is connected to a battery which will supply some charge. And the inner plate of C1, that is the plate of C1, the remaining plate of C1 is also connected to earth. So here potential is 0 and 0, and the potential at the middle shell will be V. So here we can see the charge will battery, which battery will supply will be to both of these capacitors. So the charge supplied by battery here will be C1V plus C2V. That is C1 plus C2 into V, and here we can consider the two capacitors are connected in parallel. So here the effective capacitance of this system can be written as C1 plus C2, which is 4 pi epsilon naught AB upon B minus A plus 4 pi epsilon naught B. That is the answer to this problem, the effective capacitance of this system of concentric shells.